Mr. Janai, anything that you want to say on behalf of yourself?
I'd like to say, Your Honor, that bottom of my heart, I want to give my apologies to any of the family members of the woman that may be here. I just want everyone to know that since this happened, it's been very hard for me to live with this. And I wish it never happened. And I just want them to know that I'm very sorry. I didn't mean for that to happen. And I hope God gives them strength to get through this. And I just want to say that through this whole tragic incident, I've learned a lot, and I've bettered myself a lot. And I've realized a lot of things, what matter in life, and the importance of family. And I took some good out of the bad, and I just hope that I could get through this and be a good part of the community again one day.
All right, thank you. Ms. Verlander, anything on behalf of the probation department? Anything on behalf of the people?
Yes, Your Honor. I want to make the court aware that Ms. Linda Kaya, the deceased in this case, her son, Aunt, or Tony Majid, is here. He's with the translator. He does not wish to speak himself, but he did ask me to pass on to the court that when in determining your sentence, that you do keep in mind that himself, his siblings have both lost a mother in this, and that the youngest of the siblings, Randy Majid, who is the other victim in this case, hit and broke his pelvis. It's in the report that he does have autism, he doesn't speak. At this point, he can't even understand that his mother was gone. He asks everything for his mother, his siblings and family, to tell him every day she's gone, and try to explain to him that's the case. So that's how it's impacted his family.
Well, the court can't even begin to comprehend how it's impacted the family. Sir, your actions, and I understand this is one night, this is one incident, that you have no prior felonies, you have no prior misdemeanors, but you robbed a family of their mother due to what you had done. And one of the children, one of which that you had struck that night and had potentially irreparably damaged, that was the person that he had relied upon. And now I don't know who they're going to turn to as far as care, specifically the young man that was struck by yourself. He's nonverbal, and how do you explain to him that his mother is now gone? It's tragic all the way around, and you seem contrite. I don't have any reason to believe that you're not remorseful. That this is an aberration for what had occurred here, and it's tragic. As you said, it's tragic for your family as well. But there are consequences to your actions and what you did, and particularly because of what had occurred after the incident, the egregiousness of you trying to cover up what had occurred and not stopping to render aid. That is also a consideration for this court. The policy of the State of Michigan favors individualized sentencing for every convicted defendant. The sentence must be tailored to fit the particular circumstances of the case as well as the defendant. At the time of the plea arrangement, the court was apprised as to the circumstances of this incident as well as to the defendant. The court had indicated that a COPS of two-thirds of the sentencing guidelines would be appropriate. And the court recognized and still recognizes that, sir, you are contrite, that you have spared the family the ordeal of a trial, but the two-thirds of the sentencing guidelines does seem to be wholly appropriate. And because of that, the court is going to sentence you to 71 months to 15 years with 2 days served. You are to pay restitution, and there's not an indication as to what the restitution amount is. Because there's no indication as to what restitution is, it's going to be set at zero. You must comply with DNA testing. That's $60. And do I have that right, Mr. Hall? We don't have any.
I don't have it.
Pay $204 state court costs, crime victim rights assessment in the amount of $130, and court costs is $600. That's all on counts 1, 3, and 5. On counts 2, 4, and 6, you are to serve 2 years and 6 months to 5 years within the Michigan Department of Corrections, and credit for 2 days served. You must pay $204 state court costs. You are entitled, as a matter of constitutional right, to file an application for leave to appeal your conviction and sentence. If you're financially unable to retain a lawyer, the court will appoint a lawyer to represent you on your appeal. Request for assistance of a lawyer must be made within 42 days. A form is now being handed to you by the court clerk with which you can make this request. Please acknowledge receipt of the form by signing the return receipt.
I will sign it.
All right, thank you. Good luck, sir.
Thank you.